Hundreds of people are at the beach, soaking up the hot summer sun. What's that? Something catches your eye. You look up at the sky and see an aurora? People around you start taking out their phones to post a picture of the spectacle. Suddenly, everyone loses their phone signal. Something strange is going on. A stream of solar particles is crashing into the Earth's magnetic field at speeds of up to 8 million kilometers per hour. You might want to be prepared because the worst is yet to come. Here's what you can do to survive a solar storm.
The sun is always showering Earth with a mist of magnetized particles known as solar wind. For the most part, our planet's magnetic shield blocks this electric wind from doing any real damage to Earth or its inhabitants, instead sending those particles skittering toward the poles and leaving behind a pleasant aurora in their wake. But sometimes, every century or so, that wind escalates into a full-blown solar storm and, as new research presented at the SICKM 2021 Data Communication Conference warns, the results of such extreme space weather could be catastrophic to our modern way of life. In short, a severe solar storm could plunge the world into an internet apocalypse that keeps large swaths of society offline for weeks or months at a time.
On July 19th, 2012, the Solar Dynamics Observatory captured this incredible footage of the sun. This clip was recorded with one frame every 12 seconds, meaning every second of this video represents 6 minutes of real time. This event began with an intense solar flare, a sudden release of magnetic energy sending ungodly amounts of energy in the form of radiation and light into space. This particular solar flare was followed by a coronal mass ejection, a massive twisted bubble-shaped eruption firing a colossal cloud of electrically charged particles into space, which can disrupt interplanetary magnetic fields and interact with Earth's magnetic field in what is known as a geomagnetic storm. Finally, as the solar storm subsided and the eruption bubble began to cool, we were treated to one of the most mesmerizing events in our solar system, coronal rain, where the remaining charged plasma cools and falls back to the surface of the sun, forming these beautiful cage-like structures as the particles follow the sun's magnetic field lines back down. An astoundingly beautiful event, but had it happened just a week earlier, the flare would have been pointing squarely at Earth, and it wouldn't have been the first time a solar storm affected life negatively on Earth. In 1859, a similarly powerful solar flare called the Carrington event did hit Earth, treating people as far south as the Caribbean to the Northern Lights, while also knocking out major telegraph systems in both Europe and North America. In some cases, the geomagnetic disturbances were so strong that they sparked fires, shocked telegraph operators, and even allowed the telegraph system to work with no power. In 1989, a large geomagnetic storm caused a blackout in Quebec after the coronal mass ejection managed to trip circuit breakers in their grid, leaving 6 million people without power for 9 hours. So clearly, these storms have the power to really mess with vital technologies that keep our society moving.
However, the long undersea internet cables that connect continents are a different story. These cables are equipped with repeaters to boost the optical signal, spaced at intervals of roughly 30 to 90 miles, 50 to 150 kilometers. These repeaters are vulnerable to geomagnetic currents, and entire cables could be made useless if even one repeater goes offline, according to the paper. If enough undersea cables fail in a particular region, then entire continents could be cut off from one another, Abdujioti wrote. What's more, nations at high latitudes, such as the US and the UK, are far more susceptible to solar weather than nations at lower latitudes. In the event of a catastrophic geomagnetic storm, it's those high-latitude nations that are most likely to be cut off from the network first. It's hard to predict how long it would take to repair underwater infrastructure, but AbduGOT suggests that large-scale internet outages that last weeks or months are possible. In the meantime, millions of people could lose their livelihoods. When the next big solar storm does blast out of our star, people on Earth will have about 13 hours to prepare for its arrival. Let's hope we're ready to make the most of that time when it inevitably arrives. It has been suggested that a geomagnetic storm on the scale of the solar storm of 1859 today would cause billions or even trillions of dollars of damage to satellites, power grids and radio communications, and could cause electrical blackouts on a massive scale that might not be repaired for weeks, months, or even years. Solar storms aren't dangerous to humans on Earth's surface. These storms are awesome to contemplate, but they cannot harm our human bodies as long as we remain on the surface of Earth, where we're protected by Earth's blanket of atmosphere. Remember, there's every reason to believe that storms on the Sun have been happening for billions of years, since the Sun and Earth came to be. If that's so,
here's what you can do to survive a solar storm. A coronal mass ejection is a massive burst of plasma and electromagnetic radiation released from the Sun. The good news is that Earth's magnetosphere and atmosphere shield us from these dangerous particles. But even though solar storms can't hurt us physically, they can seriously affect our technology. One of the most devastating solar flares to hit Earth happened in 1859. The Carrington event. The radiation shocked operators and set telegraph pylons on fire. Today, in the worst-case scenario, an intense solar storm could overload our electric grids, sending our world into a blackout. So, what can you do to prepare for a solar storm? Why should you avoid traveling during one? And why might you want to withdraw some cash from the bank right now? Step 1. Prepare ahead of time. The main threat you'll have to face during a solar storm is a blackout. That means no electricity, no communications, no internet, and no social media? You've got a better chance of surviving a blackout if you prepare beforehand. Have the essential items you'd need for any type of disaster. Doomsday preppers recommend a 30-day supply of food and water. Stock up on non-perishable foods like canned goods and dried foods, since your fridge won't be working. Each person in your household will need about 4 liters of water each day. Now that you have the necessities on hand for any disaster, what should you do when a solar storm blackout happens? And what if you didn't prepare in advance? Step 2. Save your food. Grocery stores may run out of food with the disruption of supply chains, and if you can't grow your own food, you'll have to save your food for as long as possible. If your water supply is still working, fill up your bathtub and other containers with water. Keep your fridge closed as much as you can. There won't be any electricity, but that should keep your food at a safe temperature for about 4 hours. Your freezer should stay cold for about 48 hours. And don't forget to eat your fruits and veggies. Those are the foods that will spoil first. Step 3. Secure your house. During the day, find and collect matches, flashlights, or any other sources of light. You wouldn't want to be stuck in the dark, and we wouldn't recommend making a fire in your house. While you're searching, make sure to lock all the windows and doors. Keep your home safe from intruders and burglars when disaster strikes. And reach out to your neighbors. See if there's anything you can help them out with. In tough times like this, they might not be prepared. Or they might just need a friend to talk to. Step 4. Don't travel. When a solar storm strikes, the last place you'd want to be is up in the air. Being at a high altitude can increase your risk of being exposed to solar radiation. Not only that, but with satellite communications down, the plane's navigation system won't work. Planes could end up traveling in the wrong direction, and some might even collide. And don't even think about riding the subway. If you think that your rush hour commute is horrible now, imagine what it would be like if the system stops during a solar storm. Step 5, get some cash. Depending on how badly the power grids are damaged, it could take years to repair them all. If there's no system in place to supply food and water, you might need money to buy some. And since there's no electricity to power the ATMs and banks, you'll only have the money you have on hand. Break out that piggy bank and crack open your swear jar. Hopefully, our communities won't plunge into chaos and lead to an economic collapse. Don't join that angry mob. We've got just the video to help you on how to survive.